Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I decided I'm going to use Stamps by Me, Set Me Free Hummingbird stencil and die set. Excuse me. Anyways, I'm also going to be using Diamond Press paint sticks and glitter paste, this teal color. What I want to do is I want to make a sun capture with this, and the sun's coming in on my window here. So what I did, I'm going to cut it. I cut it out of vellum. So I have one of them light hold sticky sheets. I never use this. So let me put this in here quick, hoping I can get this vellum off, because that's what I'm going to use as the sun catcher. To be too full, I'm probably going to take this underneath here so I'll be able to pull this up. There we go. Just a little tape not to put it too far. And that black paper that I got from Dollar Tree, I pre-cut these out. There's a shiny side and there's a dull side. And when I cut up, I used this shiny side, but when I went to pull this apart, some of this backing came off, but that doesn't matter because it's going to be pinned in between here. So what I did was I flipped it backwards, put the shiny side toward the bottom of the die and cut it, because when I put this together, you can't put the two rough ends together. And I figured this way the shiny is on the outside on both the inside and that. So that should work like that. So I have them pre-cut out already. So just the top and the bottom. And I did find out these stencils have numbers right in here. They're marked from 1 to 6. And I'm going to start off with number 1. And I'm going to make my registration marks. These are little hearts. And I'm going to use a pencil, because it doesn't matter. This is going to be cut out anyhow when you cut the shape of the hummingbird out. Just need to do 3 of them to make sure that I line them all up. I'm just going to use a piece of washi tape on the bottom and the top here. Okay, so I was playing with the paint markers. They're not creamy. They dry chalky on vellum. And I went and watered it, and it kind of bubbled my paper and everything. And I went back, and it like washes it completely. I use the dauber and it washes it like completely off. So I'm just gonna use the paint stick directly on it. These are a little bit different than the creamy like gelato and the other ones that they had before. And even different from these, I wanna use this color too. Different from this art scale. So I'm just going to put this on top and I'm going to blend it in like this. Now this is going to go on kind of thick because I'm pushing in thick and everything. But that's okay because I want to make sure it all fills in nice. And I don't know if this is going to take a while to dry or not because of the way the thickness that I'm putting this on. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and kind of blend it in with the pen or the, because I was trying to figure out, you know, how to make sure that I got coverage. Now, I don't know if I should heat gun this. I mean, you know how vellum gets too. And this is all washable with water and that, so All right. And it, now that I worked with it here now, it seems to be more creamier. Let me pull this up. I'm gonna go slow. Oh, I went too heavy. Look, I went in there. All right, so I'm gonna take maybe a little dauber. Try to wipe that clean. Because I never did this before and I don't know how. Yeah. I have to watch when I'm putting pressure on it. Yeah, I'm going to spray this a little bit with water. See if I can lift it up with it. That works. Like I said, this will be cut out. Now it did add a little thickness to it. I'm wondering if I'm gonna have to wait to dry this. This may not work the way I want it to. Because now I'm thinking I can't put the next layer on or I'm going to mush that color. I'm going to have to wait until it dries. Okay, I'm going to hit pause and get back to you. I'm going to clean this off and try to heat this, set this, and if we don't, we'll start all over again and see what happens. Okay, hold on. Okay, I hit it with heat and it did dry it. It just is like a texture. So I'm gonna keep going to see what happens because we're gonna find out if it will work or not. I think it kind of warped my sticky mat now. Since I hit it with heat. Okay, this one I was gonna use the yellow. This is probably gonna do the same thing. What I'm gonna do though this time is I'm gonna try to like stay right here. And it seems that it's filling in the cracks. It's just going on thick. Let me see how this looks. Okay, it don't look bad. All right. Take it off tape. I'm gonna hit it with heat again. Try to get this. Seems like it dries really quick, too. Okay. Still not sure about these, paint sticks. They're different. It's something different. It's something that you have to kind of get used to, I think. Oops, here. Make sure I'm on all the hearts. It's just really warping this whole light hold. See, I can't even get myself on the, and my hands are sticking to it. Okay, so now I want to use this lighter pink and twist it up. Okay, I just want to make sure that maybe I'm putting it on too thick. I paint heavy though, so that's another thing. I really paint heavy. I've always done that. This is I'm just going across, just trying to fill in the holes where I can see where that, I hope this turns out nice. Really. But live and learn with vellum. I'm going out and going in circles. See here. The name of the game is to get messy here. Yeah, I was really excited about trying these pastel colors. And maybe I'm going to have to paint with them to see how I like working with them as painting. They seem chalky drying when I went and sampled with them on that vellum. I just wanted to see how, if it would go on the vellum. And they really, they don't have a, like a glossy look, like glass or, not glass. They don't have that shimmer. That's what I'm thinking of. But this is more like, what is it? Gesso, I'm thinking of. But I kind of do like the way it gives it a different texture, too. Okay, let's see how this looks. Yeah, it looks like it's starting to turn into the hummingbird. All right, let me hit it again. It looks like you got to hit it with the heat gun for it to dry. See it. It don't take long. It's, well, that one's a little pasty yet. Hang on. That one I gotta hit again. Okay, the next layer, I want to use the darker pink. Now, I don't know this, my darker pink is, wonder if I should just use, no, I won't. I was going to say I was going to use glitter paste, but then I have to really wait until it dries. Wonder if I should use purple. No, I have purple for the next color. Yeah, this one is not creamy. I'm going to show you. This does not, like, this is hard. It will work, but it has some shine and shimmer to it. So I'm going to have to go like this with it. This is fun. This is something different out of my comfort zone. I did stenciling before, but not this many layers before neither. So, and I do like Tony's products, her stamp by me. She has beautiful things. I'm gonna have to open this up more. This has glitter in it also, this paint stick. So this will add some shimmer to it, along with the last, I'm gonna put the glitter paste into it. I'm just going over it to make sure that I have everything filled in, because it's hard to see. Okay. Let me close this one. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's really turning out pretty nice. It's better than what I was imagining. Oops. I guess I better hit that with the heat gun, too. Sorry for the heat gun noise, but I just want to make sure it's dry before it. And it's building up layers, too. Now, this one I want to do in purple. As soon as I find my registrations. There you go. It's like pushing up on the set, or because of the texture on the, and also my mat. I think that has a lot to do with it, because the mat's warping from the heat of the heat gun. I turn this over. I can't even get my thing to stay stuck on here. I just hold it with my fingers. Okay, this is my purple. There's not much purple anyhow. Now this is more creamy. I don't know, it just probably depends on the colors, I guess. Oh, see, now this bled more into there at the bottom. A little rough looking at the bottom. But maybe once you put that black layer on, you won't see it neither. Okay, I'm going to hit that with the glue or the heat gun again. Sorry for this heat gun noise. This is the only way I know how to get it to dry nice. Hopefully when I go to lift this off, that it's not going to tear my vellum. Because you know how fragile vellum is. Yep, that one's dry. Okay. Now, I have to line this up. Where did I put my tape? Oh, my tape's still stuck on that other one. Let me tear another couple pieces off. Because this one I'm going to have to stick down, because moving the paste around. See, it just does not want to hold. My mat is so warped right now from the heat. Put this over here, because this one. I'm going to use this one. And I love playing with this paste. I had used this on that one graduation book that I did. This you gotta keep flat though. I know that. Because of this matte so warped, it is pushing up. See that? It went underneath. Maybe I can cut that out. Darn. Darn, darn. Yeah, I got a mess here a little bit. I think it will cover it as I'm looking. I just have to get the wings here. And more of this and this. Yeah, this became a little messy. Oh, but it does look pretty. That I can wash out too. I just washed this with soap and water and everything. I'm gonna take that over to wash that. And I'm going to stop this right now, and then I'll be back, and we'll go from here after I dry it. Okay, I got everything washed up now, and I'm going to start peeling this off. My mat is a little warped, but that's okay. I'll hit the heat gun on that slowly. That's the back of it. And I hit the heat gun on this, so it seems to be doing pretty good. And I washed these. They come out back to good again. So there's an outline die to cut this. And I just want to make sure. See, I think the boo-boos will be covered. See that? I have to figure out how to lay it. But now the question is, can I get this to lay nice and flat? This one, I think I'm going to have to scrape a little bit because I do think this is going to show. I wonder if I can scrape it off. See, you learn. I don't think I'm going to be able to. Well, we'll see once I, it's definitely going to show. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to figure out here. Because I'm going to have to run this through the, this might have a little margin. Okay, I'm going to tape this down to run through my cutter. I'm gonna have to hit pause again until we get this, because I don't have my tangerine on this side. Okay, hold on. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. And I did put it through the cutter, and it is definitely probably gonna show this on there. It looks, I gotta line it up here. But I don't think it looks too bad. So I'm going with it this way. Okay. So What I'm going to do is I'm going to take, I need a little string that I gotta hook that up. Something thin. To glue it. Just something to glue onto the back half to hang it in the window. Okay. So I'm going to glue my hand up here and dab this on. Because this is fine, and I am going to have a mess on my hand here, but that's okay. There's a lot of fine detail in this. I'm going to have my arm glued all up here shortly. Make sure that I have all of it covered so it sticks. This has like a plastic coating on the paper. I thought that was. So I'm gonna try lining it up to the beak and go down like this. Let me run my brayer over the top of this to make sure I got it stuck on there. There we go. That didn't turn out bad. In the back half, once we get the other piece put on the back half. And look, you can't even really see. You can see it, but you can't. My board wouldn't have warped. I think it would have been better. Okay. So I'm going to flip this over. And I'm going to do the back half. But before I do that, I wonder if I should just poke a hole in. Now I gotta decide. Instead, I was gonna try gluing it in here, but you're gonna see it that way. Okay, let me just glue this down. I might have to what you call it? Put an eyelet in there, not an eyelet. Oh, yeah, I guess it is an eyelet to string that through to make it a little more sturdy to hang, because you just stick these on these wind catchers, sun catchers, just go. Oh, this card nicer. Trying to line it up to the black that I can see where the other black is. There we go. That looks pretty muted too. Yeah. is the prayer again. Go across this way. Wow, that side is pretty. Let me clean off my hand a little bit. I'm doing this all the time. I create new skin for myself. Okay. That doesn't look bad at all. It looks pretty on both sides. The thing is, I have to figure out if I punch a hole in to put an eyelet. Do you want to do it at the wing? I mean, you could do it at the wing and have it like fluttering, or do it in the center and have it like that. Both sides are pretty though. Okay, let's decide here. I should go with the black one. I don't really need a big hole. Is, or should I string it in there and then it will look like it's flying up? Or should I string it in that one? Keep it. All right, I'll do it in this one. I'm gonna punch it right there. Oh, the hole's not big enough. All right, I gotta go with the bigger hole. So I can get that Brad in there. Or that, not Brad. This piece here. Punch it through the vellum. Look at that. Nice. And when you're doing this, you gotta make sure that, wait, it goes like this, that this, piece goes through the top piece and then the little piece, and I'm going to squish it. See that? Very nice. Now to go up here. Maybe I should have made my string longer, huh? Maybe not. Wait, maybe I should sew. Yeah, I need a longer string. That's too short. Let's get a longer string. Okay. And I'll loop it through this hole here. That way it's holding it secure. And tie a little knot up here. And there we go. We have a cute little wind catcher. Or sun catcher. Not a wind catcher. Sun catcher. That worked out pretty nice. And it's somewhat thick, because of layering the back to it. Now you can feel this is the roughness, but I do like this side. It will look pretty even outside the window from the inside. I think it turned out pretty cool. Well, thanks for joining me and liking and subscribing. This was a fun project, a little messy, but you learn. My review on those paint crayons, I think I got to get used to them. I got to try them ones different, because this was vellum. And I don't want to misjudge on how I feel about them until I try them one cardstock and that. And vellum is a touchy thing. I was going to do it on acetate, but the acetate, I think, would have been, that it wouldn't have stuck. That's because that's what I was worried after I started. I was thinking it wasn't going to stick on the vellum, but it worked out pretty good. And it has like depth of the way it stuck on and came around and everything. And I'm glad I did use that other paint with the glitter in it that I had in my stock, because that just added the finishing touches on that pink. The glitter paste does just finishes off the Hummingbird, because of them. They do have an iridescent look and everything. But yep, thank you, and hope you try something like this. This was, I never tried this before, and this was fun. And I look at your dies and see what you have. And thank you, Tony, from Stamping Stamps by Me. I love your product, and I think that this really is a nice one to work with, the Hummingbird cards, and now you can make sun catchers out of it. All right, have a great day, and see you all next time. Bye bye.